Here in Photoshop, we're going to have a look at how we use the pen tool to make a vector line in Photoshop, and then how we stroke that with a brush, basically. Okay, so at the moment we're just using the brush tool, and a lot of the time we're painting with the mouse, which is kind of clunky and awkward a lot of the time. Okay, so you can't get a nice smooth flowing line. So one way of remedying that, if you don't have access to a pen tablet that you can use as an interface to draw into the computer, is to use the pen tool in Photoshop. Okay, so I'm just going to deselect this by doing Command and D and grab the pen tool on the bottom left down here. And basically the pen tool allows us to draw a vector line, so we can draw from point to point. Okay, and at the moment I've got this set up just as a path, so it's not even going to be visible in our final exported out Photoshop document. It's just going to be the vector's there, but there's nothing on that vector. There's no kind of stroke on that or anything like that. Okay, so it sets a path at the moment. We'll use this for making shapes a little bit later on. But what we can do with the brush tool is actually stroke this path. Okay, I'm going to make a different path before I stroke it. Okay, so basically with the pen tool, we can make a curve, a smooth curve. Okay, and the way we do that with the pen tool is by clicking and holding. Okay, and you can see I'm dragging out these handles along the edges of this vector line. Okay, so you can see I've got a lot of control over how I draw that line and the angle that I have that at, and it's not just a question of kind of moving through it and drawing it. Okay, it's not sometimes as nice as using a kind of physical pen tablet and drawing into the computer, but it will give you a nice result if you spend a bit of time with it. Okay, once we've drawn our line, before we stroke it, we want to look at how we can edit it. Okay, so how we could kind of adjust the points or the angle of the points, and we do that by using this tool down here, the direct selection tool, which is what we used last week for editing the points on the polygon that we created. Okay, so basically this can be used to move these points around so we can manipulate it along with the handles here into the shape that we want it to be. Okay, so this is similar to the kind of bezier lines that you'll be creating in Illustrator. Okay, the difference is that once we've made that, we can grab the brush tool, we can set up our brush for a certain size and hardness. Okay, and then we can stroke that path with that brush. Okay, so once we've got the brush selected, in our layers panel on the bottom right, if we click there, you'll see we've got three tabs. We've got the layers, channels, which we'll come to a little bit later on, and paths, which is where we've drawn this kind of path, which at the moment is going to be invisible if we print it out or export this out. But we're going to select that path, the work path, and then come down to the bottom of the paths tab there and just click this button, stroke path with brush. Okay, and basically it's going to stroke that brush along the path. So we can pick any color that we want. And he says, stroke the path with it. Okay, and if we wanted to, we could make slight adjustments to the path, which is one nice way of using this. So we could stroke it once, make some slight adjustments to it, to the angle of some of these points, come back to the brush tool, select a different color, okay, and then come down and stroke it again. Okay, so we can manipulate that path and get a nice smooth flowing line in this way. Okay, so click and hold. Okay, and unless we save that work path, it's gonna delete it once we've used it. Okay, so you can see I've got a new work path there, which is this one, but my old work path has been deleted. If I wanted to save it, I drag it down to this new layer button here in the paths panel, and then that's going to save it as path one. Okay, it's not a work path anymore, it's a permanent path that I can use and reuse. Okay, so I can come back to my brush tool, select a different color, and then come down and stroke it, and then go ahead and move this, adjust it, and then use it again with the brush tool to make a different shape. Okay, and you can see that you're getting a nice smooth flowing line, which you're not getting probably when you're painting with the mouse or other with the mouse when you're using the brushes at the moment. Okay.